Okay, carb number two is a little different. And a little spookier. We're going to get the top cap on. And go from there. This is how I, excuse me, this is how I pulled it out of the parts bin. This is the choke idler. That's the choke idler spring right there. But from the drawing, it appears I have it backwards. And that is entirely possible. That's how they show it. That little washer is from my hardware kit. Okay, folks, after some finagling, going back, watching my video, reading the pamphlet again, looking at the book, I am about 95% sure this is how carb 2 goes back together. Let's see if I can get some better light. Get your eyes on that. Front of the carb. This needs to be... keep losing. There we go. There we go. See how that bar... right there on this mounting bracket is above this arm that swings, and this bracket is held in by the screw. Notice how this bracket is above that and below this, and this all slides in and the screw goes through and holds it all together. Anyhow, I'll try to get this focused up so everybody can kind of see how that fit together. My head hurts after all that thinking. So, before I forget, that little spring catches on this nub with like a half cut out on it. Anyhow, my head hurts from all that thinking. I'm going to clean out the needle seat and take a little brain break. All right, next up on carb number two is the accelerator pump that goes in this spot. Drop that in and line up two holes right there. All right, it appears the cover only goes one way. Set the spring down. Make sure my holes are lined up. This might be aggravating. Working my way around and snugging. Not getting anything too tight yet, just a little snug. Okay, there's that. Now, I would like to test this. So I've got to put gas in the bowl, and we'll do that here in a second. While I'm at it, before I test the bowl, I'm going to go ahead and put in my drain plug. That way I'll know if my drain plug is good. I didn't test the other ones, I just trusted it, but if I'm going to be testing one thing, I'll probably test another. Goes in number two. I am going to clean this a little bit. I'm gently. All right, accelerator pump test. Gas in the bowl. And should come out of right there. Took a few primes, but see if you can watch right here by my finger. Haha, winning. All right, now that pump is confirmed to work. I'm going to pull this little rubber piece out. Man, the lighting's terrible. Take my word for it. There's a little rubber piece right here, and that accelerator pump shaft runs up and down in it. They sent a new piece. I have it. It's rubber. There it is. I want to put the new one on. I don't know if I can fit my big meat mitts in there, but I'll try. That may have been a mistake. I'll get it in. Real careful with this because I don't want to puncture it or dork it up. There. Okie dokie. Need to look at my instructions and see what's next. And get that done. Well, I've got one little O-ring that's holding me up. I didn't get it ordered when I ordered everything else. So I'm just going to keep working on what I can work on. And we'll deal with all that later. Put the secondary in. Yep, just gonna do what I can do. Flat washer, O-ring. Yep. One, half, two, half. Alright, that's set. I wonder if I could get by without that O-ring. Didn't come out of it. That is a tempting thought. For the sake of assembly, I could put it together and be able to continue. And I can always take this carb bolt back off from underneath. You don't have to split the whole assembly to do that. I might just do that. Well, I successfully shoved that rubber boot up out of its hole. Fish that back in. And I guess if I put gas to this, and it doesn't leak, it's not going to matter. All right, last thing left is the air cut.